voice chatter from the time by chatter. I am a graphic designer, a wife, a mom to two kids, and a dog. I am profoundly deaf. My husband and my son are deaf too, and my daughter is hearing. The girl, three of her are deaf, and she's the only one in the family is hearing. But, no, we hope to fit them so well, and yeah, we've never left out any of my kids. I cheat on both of them, and yeah. I will be talking about my journey being deaf and how I run my own business, how I communicate when I'm crying, and how I stay positive, and I not let my deafness stop me from doing anything. I think I'm quite a determined person, so I think that helped a lot. I want to help young children with disabilities and help them feel confident. I want to be able to help them have a positive mindset, find the right support, and make sure they get the right accessible, make sure they have the right accessibility, because it's so important to have in the business. Today is the launch of my new podcast, and I thought I'd start my first episode about myself and why I want to start my podcast and to help people, especially young children. I will be sharing my journey from when I was a child and up till now, because I feel there aren't enough information out there and it can be quite difficult. So I thought if I share my journey and then more people will share their journey and then people can look up and see how they can be able to have a job, or how they cope in businesses, and how what's out there to help them. I want to raise more awareness as well. If you're a parent with a child who is deaf and you're worried about the threat and what help is there to help them, well, this is the podcast for you. Then you can listen and follow my journey, how I manage. I'm going to have a couple of questions and I'm going to answer them, so I thought it being what my podcast is about. The first question is, how can I hear and what made me start my podcast? For 30 years, I wore hearing aids. I've had them since I was born. And then 2 years ago, I decided to get a cochlear implant. I struggled with my hearing aid, and seeing my son who'd got a cochlear implant, I was amazed how much it helped him. I thought I wouldn't see if it was for me or if it would make a difference, but I've been rebuilding and making sure I was making the right decision. 2 years later, I was amazed, it changed my life. I've heard so many things that I haven't heard before, like the bus, stunning, tweeting, it's so raw. And the most important thing for me is the fire alarm. I check when it goes off, I knew what it was. And it's so high pitch. I never heard high pitch before. And I was pretty amazed, to be honest. It also made me have more confidence, especially in business, meeting new people. I was able to go on Zoom to do my meeting. I was able to join on the training, different coaches. I would have done that if I had hearing aids, because it picked up more sound that I was able to live with. It hugged the brain up. I'm hoping to, in my YouTube videos, I can show you how it all works, what I can do. It'll be good to see so you can help your deaf child or anybody that wants to start their own business. I just want to say everybody is different. There are people who need BSL, which is British Sign Language, or they wear hearing aid, or they have a cochlear implant. Each people have their own cause, and we all need to respect that. We all have a story, and we do what we think work best for yourself. I was doing really well with hearing aid. It didn't stop me from doing anything though. But I want to do something a little bit better, and I've seen it with my son, I've seen how it works, and I carefully researched it and made that decision, and it worked for me. But some people might be happy with hearing aid, or they might be happy with dying. We're all different, and we have different personality, and we choose what we think best for ourselves. I love watching YouTube videos about business and inspirational women. That made me, first of all, that's how I run my business. Follow people who inspire me, and I think how I work for me being there, like the podcast, is so popular. I wanted to be the same as other women who talk on the podcast, but I kept thinking, will my death may stop me? And I thought, no, enough is enough. Give it a go, and I can make it work for me. Which is why I'm doing the both podcast, and then I'm going to record it onto video for my on YouTube, so I can add captain. Do I have two different platforms that people can choose? I am able to follow other people's podcast who doesn't have captain available. And you're probably thinking, how? Well, I know that app called Otter, and but there will be a link to my description. I open the podcast app on my Mac, and then on my phone, I open my Otter app, and it was transcribe the podcast onto my phone, and it would tell me everything, but I don't read it. Once it's funny, I save it, and then I keep it for later on, so I can read it on my phone like a book. But I will link the app below, then you can have a wee look. That is the example why I always like to find a way to be able to get involved, and you can find a way to make it work. It should be simple, but I think it's better than nothing at all. It may be a harder or maybe a longer way, but I make it work. Another question is, how do I use social media for my business? I have spoken on live and recorded videos. I was comfortable doing them. But when I did a live showing people how to use Canva, I got so nervous. And I felt something wasn't right, and it wasn't going to work for me. I managed to finish the whole video though. And afterwards I thought to myself, why I didn't feel right about it. And you know what? I couldn't multitask. I couldn't talk at the same time, showing people how to use Canva at the same time, and then the captain was not picking up my words today. I was losing confidence at that point, and I got overwhelmed. But I kept going, because I felt I could learn from the video. I could have taken it down. But I didn't, I left it there to show people that I'm the only one whose life went wrong. And instead of being negative about it, I decided, well, there must be a way. And there was, I came up with a new plan. You can make it work, just do it you and your business. I feel more excited doing this way, and I know I will feel more relaxed and more myself. And it would suit me and everybody else. So just do what feels right. The video I'm talking about is for my Facebook group, for people who want to learn how to use Canva, how to create a temporary, how to do the design for their own business. If you'd like to join my group, I will add that below as well. Also, when you're on Instagram doing videos, and live, and talking on stories, people find this so hard to do. But you don't have to stone yourself or talk to the camera. I do it when I feel confident, I talk on camera, but when I don't, I just take videos what I do in my life, like the work on my computer, or when I'm going out walking with the dog and I take pictures of a bikini, they don't have to always journal down. I do it sometimes, but I don't feel comfortable someday. It's strange. I just do what feels right for me. You can also like take pictures and then you can do collage and then add texture. There's so many ways you can do that. And you will make it work for you and your personality will show people who you are and what you feel comfortable with. You're being true to yourself and that's important. That is one of my favourite quotes. Personality begins where comparison leaves off. Be unique, be memorable, be confident, be proud. I always have that in my head. And always leave a positive favourite quote in my head and repeat that every time you feel, I can't do it on the other. I always repeat my quote and it gives me a positive mindset. What I'm hoping my podcast will do? Well, I'm hoping to make everybody, well, everyone, especially in businesses, aware how important accessibility is for deaf people or people with hard of hearing or any other disability. This is quite sad, but I have to say most big companies don't have captions in their videos or mention what support available at the end of the courses. I always have to email and ask, oh, what support do you have available? It would take forever to organise support for me. So should I already have it set up with captain or provide notes? There are also most apps available that can help them, like to transcribe audio, Zoom, captain. You can have, there's so many you can do. I just feel it's not being advertised or showing them that they are available to help people with hearing difficulties. I want to help companies and businesses on how to make their business more accessible because they're going to lose clients who have hearing difficulties. And if we want more people to come to the business then be more accessible, it's the best way to help your business. If you'd like to contact me and find out more information on how you can help your business, my email is below in the description box. Send me an email and I will be more than happy to have a chat and then see how I can help you. Also, in my podcast, in a couple of episodes, I will have guest speakers. So I'm so excited because it's going to be more relaxed. I'm going to be talking about businesses and how we can offer more support for deaf people who want to start their own business or do some training. Because I know finding jobs can be so hard, especially at this time. I mean, it feels really like, it makes you feel, it's so tiring and I know it's so hard. But you can learn so many things, like doing courses, learn, like, there's so many ways you can do and then add to the CV. And that's what I want to change as well, help deaf people with the CV, add more experience, like training courses and stuff, and make sure they have captions so they can get involved too. I want to change that as well. I want to be able to, people to be more aware. So I'll give you an example on how I can change. There are a lot of business coaches out there and I just want to make sure the captain are on the video or they provide workbook so we can fill them in and we can write these as well, so it's quite good to have. Also if they were doing a Zoom, they can share the screen and they can have slideshows. We had all the information on it and we can take pictures on a phone or write them down. So we have it as well and you can captain. It's good to have too many things that are to do as well as you can captain. I feel I do miss out on Instagram. That is the most popular platform and out of brain why. Do you know how a lot of people have started to do lives on Facebook and Instagram? Well, Facebook Live is quite good because they've got a caption where you can click and setting and then it comes up, so it's quite good. But I can do that on Instagram and I feel I do miss out, especially when it's two people talking. I'm gonna have to find a way how I can follow all that is new to me, and I love research and making sure the other way because I would love to be involved as much as you are. But I'm keeping positive that I will change. Facebook got captain and I'm hoping Instagram will be the same. To be fair, they do have captain in IGTV, Norway TV video editing that you can record and upload. I think you can add captions there, but when it comes to live, I don't think you can. But if anybody out there have any idea or there might be a way, let me know and I'd be happy to do that with the people as well. That's what my podcast is for. Share as much information as they share with people giving me. I want to share as much as I can so we all can help each other. Views are quite good on Instagram though. You can add graduate adult video, you can add captain, you can add text, you can that's quite good. So more people are doing videos, but quite good. The main thing that I would like to offer and people to have is to have forum with accessibility. So when someone says I am there or I need some support, the first thing you could do is send them a forum. Lots of information with accessibility that we can fill in what support we need, and then we need, because we don't want to just share, we can't do that, we should be able to do that and need to be able to support us and find accessibility. There are so many companies out there, the British Dynamics Interpreters, Electronic Note Takers, yeah, there are so many people, many professionals out there that can help you business. So, yeah, I'm hoping my podcast will raise so many awareness on how we can make a disability priority and help young people's future and also adults who want to start their own business or start a new career. And I also think recruitment companies should have accessibility and support available for deaf and hard of hearing people as well. And I would like to do, I'm really hoping I'm speaking clear and you can all understand me. But I thought I'd try it. I'm going to practice. And if you want to read the caption, it's also on the YouTube video. I am determined to try and see how it works because we need podcast. I want to be the first podcast and two people who can do that. There's so many ways we can do that. If you want to find more information about the podcast or receive weekly updates, you can sign up on the link below and I can tell them what will be happening next and who the guest speakers are, and I will make sure the captain is there, especially the guest speakers, because I do not want you to miss out. And so I'm thinking that I can make it accessible for everybody. I would love it if we can all share this podcast so we can reach out to so many people and we can help change people's future. I would like you to read and review that podcast as well. I really appreciate it. And comment below in my YouTube videos. I will also link my link to my Instagram account, Design by Cheryl, where you can see what I do every day in my job, my design work, and just how I manage and how I communicate with my clients. All that would be in my Instagram account. I would like to do Danke for listening to my first episode. Thank you everybody for the support. It means a lot to me.